All right. Hello, everybody. We are getting ready to record the Weather Talk podcast live here on the WBAL Facebook page. So stick with us. We are getting everything all set up. We're going to get ready to go. We're going to let everybody join in to the podcast, and then we're going to get started. We got some fun stuff to talk about today. So let us know if you're listening right now how the audio sounds and everything before we get started. If it doesn't sound good. I know I don't sound good. I'm going to be hacking a lot.
Were you here for the puppy this morning?
I was not here for the puppy.
You missed the puppy.
I missed the puppy, yeah.
Missed the puppy. Puppy's got a big deal in my house, apparently.
Oh!
The wife loves the puppy.
Loves the puppy.
Loves the puppy. She keeps asking, you meet the puppy? I'm like, we have three dogs. We don't need to meet anymore.
We don't need any more puppies?
No.
Puppies. See, Troy's here. Marquise is here. Marquise is here, so we can get started.
Marquise, how you doing, my friend?
Sharon's here. Hi. Amy's here. Beverly's here. Sounds good. Audio's fine. Thank
Beverly.
You, Amy. We'll see how my voice holds up, though. All right. Whenever yeah, Triple D is ready, we're going to get started.
I'm just posting on our Facebook page.
Oh, yeah. Do that first.
Hey, if you guys are here and listening, pop on over to the Weather Talk Facebook page.
And like us.
And like us.
We like to be liked. Who doesn't like to be liked?
Oh, man. There we go.
Marty says, this is the funniest hour on Facebook.
Thank you.
Thank you. We appreciate that. Although, we're not trying to be funny, so I don't know that you're laughing at us, not with us.
It happens.
Kathy says she loves our podcast.
Thank you, Kathy. There we go.
Hey, somebody's watching from Tennessee. Paul from Tennessee. Hi, Paul.
What's the weather like down there, Paul?
You guys got a little bit of snow. Well, at least in parts of Tennessee, they got snow. We're almost ready to go, folks. Stay with us. Somebody's watching from Oklahoma. Woo. Mickey's watching from Oklahoma. Hey, Mickey. Hi.
Okies. Maybe.
Wow. Thanks. Watching from the powerhouse gym, doing cardio.
You on the treadmill?
That's awesome.
Hoy Lee, how you doing?
Oh, wait. Lee? Marty says, no, not the... I didn't mean to say it was the funniest hour. It's the funnest hour.
I'll take either one.
I read it wrong.
Take either way.
We'll go either way on that, yeah. All right, we're almost ready to go, folks. Bear with us.
Yeah, this is me. It's all me.
Eric says, what's up, fellas?
What's up, Eric?
Almost started. We got some fun stuff to talk about today. We're going to discuss... folklore on how to make it snow. You know, you've heard all kinds of fun things about, wearing your PJs inside out. I found some new stuff that I think is going to be good.
La Plata is checking in.
Yeah.
Kimberly, we both read the same one. I haven't even gotten mine up yet, Kimberly.
Kimberly wants you to come put her Christmas decorations up.
Oh, man, I haven't gotten mine up yet. It snowed. It rained on Sunday. That's when we were supposed to put our decorations
up. They're watching from Woodbine and Parkton.
I have to realize the camera's right there now.
Yeah, we switched the camera. We got a different camera shot today, folks. So if we look the wrong direction, forgive us.
Sorry. Okay. I'm ready.
Ready?
Yeah.
All right, here we go. Coming up in 3, 2, 1. Hey, everybody. This is Tony Pan. We are recording the Weather Talk podcast live again on the WBAL-TV Facebook page. We got a fun show coming up here. We're going to do weather folklore on how you...
Me?
Maybe you, not you.
Not
you
me.
Can
not
make
me.
It
you.
Snow. You. That's right. You can make it snow. Oh, man. I got some new stuff. We did this last year, but I got new stuff. And I'm going to let you know when I think it is actually going to snow, because we've got the snowfall contest going on. And so far, I think a couple of people have been eliminated.
More than a couple. We've had, 2, 5, 6, 8, 10. And we've had quite a few. December 2nd.
All right. So if you picked anything past December 2nd, you're still in the game. If you picked anything in front of December 2nd, you're not in the game anymore.
If it snows today.
Yeah.
Kathy and Jeff win.
Kathy and Jeff. I don't think Kathy and Jeff are going to win, though.
Sorry, Kathy. Sorry, Jeff.
Anyhow, let's do the introductions. I am Tony Pan from WBAL-TV, and that guy over there is Triple D, Dust Devil Dave.
Hey, everybody!
He's become famous for his t-shirts. What's the t-shirt today?
Cat Sabbath.
Cat Sabbath. Not Black Sabbath.
Take off on Black Sabbath. Yes, it's an homage.
An homage to Black Sabbath. All right, so I'm going to kind of go back in time here with you, Triple D. That's right. We're going to go in the Wayback Machine. Did you know, first of all, did you know that weather people are superstitious when they do their forecasts? Kind of like athletes.
I believe it.
You know, like when I played baseball in college, if you know, I got three hits in one game, I'd wear the same socks over and over again until, you know, that kind of stuff. Although I have changed my socks today. This is not where that's going. Yeah.
What is that? Where does that smell come? Anyway.
I know, right?
Well, we have to get the maintenance in here.
So about 20 years ago, I was on the air here at WBAL-TV. It was either 96 or 97.
Okay.
And I wound up getting a nickname that stuck with me. And you probably already know this nickname.
I don't know.
Stuck with me for 20 years. Dusty.
No, I did
You've
not.
You've never heard Dusty?
I've never heard that.
To this day, I still get people coming up to me every once in a while. Really? Hey, Dusty. So let me tell you how I got that reputation. So I was on the air. I think it was the early morning show. And I was forecasting a dusting of snow.
So far, making sense.
So come about 5, 6 o'clock in the evening, we had about 6 or 7 inches worth of a dusting.
It's a lot of dusting.
On the ground. And people were just giving it to me, of course. Yeah. So I got the nickname Dusty. And, you know, everybody's wrong every once in a while. If I'm wrong once every 20 years, that's not bad.
No. Well, that's a pretty good ratio,
man. Right. Yeah, and that was the last time I was wrong.
I bet you'll admit to.
Yeah. So anyhow, so the superstition part comes in where I personally would never use the word dusting on the air for 20 years.
I don't blame
you.
Because
it sticks in the back of your head, you know?
Yeah.
So for the first time yesterday, because I wanted us to get into the snow game, because, you know, New England got smoked with all kinds of snow, this storm. We missed it again. I mean, there was like 20 inches of snow in parts of Pennsylvania and New York State.
It's bypassing us.
So last night or yesterday on the air, I used the word dusting possible. And I was like, okay, I'm going to jinx us into the snow game.
Yeah.
And it didn't work, though.
No.
So for the first time in 20 years, I used the word dusting because I was going to jinx us into getting more snow.
Nothing.
Not even I could make it snow.
Did anybody remember the nickname?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh,
I got a message on.
Thank
goodness that back
good,
in the...
Good for you guys.
Forgive me for clearing my throat once in a while.
Both.
Thank goodness back in the 90s, there was no social media, or I would have really been buried, you know?
Oh, yeah.
And don't get me wrong, I enjoy a good weather trolling every once in a while.
Of course, it's all fun and games.
But yeah, that would have been bad, you know, if you go a dusting of snow, and then you you wind up with 6 or 7 inches
it's a lot of, dust.
Of a dusting. Yeah, so everybody's saying, New York City got it good, New England's got it good. By the way, Triple D is watching the messages
here. Yes, Marquis, quite the player.
Marquis, what's he doing?
Marquis, he's saying hi to everybody.
I'm proud of you for being sociable.
There you go.
Way to go, Marquise. So we are recording this on Tuesday, December the 3rd.
Yes.
I have to mention, for those of you that are watching live and perhaps listening this afternoon later on the podcast, there is a chance we could get a little bit of snow tonight.
A little bit.
I think after midnight tonight, going into tomorrow morning, there could be a dusting of snow when you wake up on Wednesday morning in some spots.
You said dusting.
I did say it, but that was subconscious.
You said dusting, everyone.
Oh, my God, we're going to get 4 inches now,
right? Get your shovels out.
I think it's highly unlikely that somebody wins our snowfall contest tonight. Because, we're measuring, the official measurement has to come at BWI.
BWI.
So, typically, in this kind of a situation tonight, the snow would be in the colder northern suburbs.
Okay.
So, it's unlikely that any of you are going to win if you picked December 4th.
Once again, 1 inch. At BWI.
As measured
1 inch or more.
BWI.
As measured BWI. Tony's saying you're not going to get it. He's being a wet blanket.
Right. All right. So I was thinking, I tried to jinx us into getting some snow.
Tried to show.
Last year, Triple D and I did a show on weather folklore and how people tried to make it snow. It mostly comes from kids and teachers.
Of course.
Teachers want the snow day. And
teachers want it just as bad as the kids.
You know, I found that to be true.
Yes.
Most of the time, you know, it's the kids writing to me, but more and more now, I'm getting the teachers going, come on, man!
Oh, I had a roommate who was a teacher, and she would ask, because I was here, hey, is it going to snow? Is it going to snow tomorrow? Because I want to go to Annapolis to my boyfriend's house. I was like, no, you're not getting out of work tomorrow.
Right, okay.
Sorry.
All right, so everybody wants out now. Yeah. By the way, there's somebody listening from North Carolina, too.
All right, NY.
Man, they're listening all over the country. And Sue's going, hey, Dusty, bring out that.
Now you put it out there.
I put it out there now. So, you know, Dusty is it. All right, so anyhow. So Dave and I did this show, podcast last year, on the folklore on how kids...
Yes.
Can get it to snow. And of course, the one that everybody knows about is you wear your PJs inside out.
Yes.
Now, if you're like Triple D and you have a trap door in the back, that doesn't work.
That's, so, you know, you just don't answer the door when someone comes and knocking like
right.
that. Sorry.
All right. So that's the number one. You know,
yes.
The kids wear their pajamas inside out. before they go to bed. But a couple other ones I haven't heard of here.
Okay, what do you got?
All right, number one. Flush an ice cube down the toilet the night before. For every inch of snow that you want, you put in that number of ice cubes. So if you want 3 inches of snow, if you think that's enough to get out of school, you drop 3 ice cubes down the toilet.
I've heard the ice cube thing. I haven't heard the more ice cubes you dump in the toilet, the more... Yeah, then we're
That's the part I didn't. I didn't know about either. So I heard about the ice cube thing. All right, so kids, if you want it to snow tonight and get out of school with a surprise dusting of 6 inches of snow, you put 6 ice cubes down the toilet tonight before you go to bed.
For all of our sakes, just don't take a handful of ice cubes. Just
count. We don't want to, 20 inches of snow. Three or four is enough to get
you out of school. Keep it reasonable. You went out of school, you don't want to close down the city.
Exactly. In Maryland, all you need is 3 or 4 inches to get out of school.
Count the Baltimore County, you need half an inch.
Right, exactly. All right, so the next one. Place a white crayon. It has to be a white crayon because white is snow.
Well, makes sense.
On the windowsill before you go to sleep. That one I've heard of before.
No, I've not heard of that one.
Heard that one? Okay, no, so a white crayon on the windowsill. Next one. This one I had never heard of. And I don't get the connection here, so if any of you have heard this one and get the connection, put a spoon under your bed and a penny under your pillow before you go to sleep.
What does the spoon under the bed give you?
I don't know. Any of you that are listening out there on Facebook, have you ever heard that one?
You know, and it's I'm going to out myself here. As kids, you're apt to take food to your rooms and leave it there. I'm sure I've had a spoon under my bed at some point.
And a bowl of ice cream that's,
it was ice cream at one point, not so much. So I don't know. I'm going to call shenanigans on that one.
All right. Sue says there will be clogged toilets everywhere across the state tonight because of you guys.
So, well, you know, plunger.
That's what we're trying to
plunger.
Do.
Plunger.
All right. So the spoon under the bed, penny under the pillow. I don't get it, but that's one. All right. This one, I think, is kind of funny because I was picturing, they had a picture up when on the website that I went to look at this. There was a kid yelling into the refrigerator. You go to the refrigerator, open the freezer.
Okay, the freezer.
Not the refrigerator part or it won't work. Okay. And you yell, snow day! Into the freezer. You have to have it in the freezer, not the refrigerator.
Of
if you
course.
Go to the refrigerator, it's just going to be a cold rain.
It's just going to be chilly.
Yeah.
Cold rain.
If you yell into the freezer, snow day! It'll get it going. All right.
So, any children listening to us, watching us, do this when your parents aren't paying attention to what you're doing, so you can scare the bejesus out of them.
Oh yeah, don't do it at 1 o'clock in the morning if you're yelling snow day. But it will scare them.
We take no credit for the trouble you're going to get into.
Oh, we're going to cause trouble with this stuff.
Oh yeah.
All right. This one is funny. Again, I don't get it, but run around the dining room table 12 times. And it'll make it snow.
More, it has to be 12, no more, no less.
That's right. That's what the website said. Oh. It can't be 11. It can't be 13. You have to run around the dining room table 12 times to make it snow. What do you think that comes from?
I have no idea.
12 months in a year.
Sure, why not? 12 inches in a foot. You want a foot of snow.
Okay, well, maybe that's where it came from.
I mean, I don't know. Maybe it's just a bunch of kids with too much energy.
So now...
just got to get outside.
It would make more sense to me if it was more like the ice cube thing.
Yeah.
Where you put, if you want 3 inches of snow, you put 3 ice cubes in. If you want 3 inches of snow, you run around the dining room table 3 times. But according to the website, it has to be exactly 12.
Marquise, that's just nonsense.
How do you know it's nonsense?
Try it.
It could happen.
You got a niece, a nephew, a kid, have them do it. See what
happens. No, Marquise, you run around the dining room table 12 times tonight before you go to bed. All right, and one more. You wear a colored sock, could be red, could be blue, or whatever, on your left foot.
Okay.
But you have to wear a white sweat sock on your right foot.
That's weird.
White for the snow, blue for whatever color you want. So your pants can match during the day on your left side, but on your right side, you have to put on the white sweat sock.
So I've got black socks on, so sorry.
So do I. So I'm not going to make it snow, but it only works if you go the contrast there. So there you go.
Well, why wouldn't you go blue sock? Because blue kind of signifies cold and water.
Now, you're thinking too much about this, but that's true.
If you go red, that's like heat miser.
For red. So I would probably stick with blue.
Go blue. Go blue.
Go blue on the left, snow on the white on the right, white, and there you go. And that makes snow.
So it be.
And so it is. All right. So that we had some fun with that. Suzanne says it's kind of like doing a rain dance. Deborah says, I always tell my grandkids to wear the PJs inside out. So, one's been around for a long time.
Got a listener from Idaho.
A listener from Idaho, really?
From Idaho, Ryan Dennis.
Hey, how you doing, Ryan? How you doing, man? All right, so that's it. That's all I got on that one. So if you have any of them and you want to post them on our Facebook page, I will read some of them next week if you guys have heard.
The Weather Talk Podcast Facebook page.
Yes, Weather Talk Podcast Facebook page, and we'll read some of them next week. All right, so we're into December now, and we often say that this is the start of meteorological winter. And a lot of people don't know what the heck that means. You've heard me say that phrase before,
yes.
Right? Okay. So meteorologists tend to, just for simplicity's sake, break the year up into three-month periods for the seasons.
Okay, makes
sense. So winter is December, January, February, and spring the next 3 months, and then summer, then and so on and so forth. So that's why we say meteorological winter begins on December 1st. But the astronomical winter, the solstice, isn't until the 21st this year. At 11:19 in the evening for the East Coast. And on that day, that's the shortest day of the year.
Okay.
We get 9 hours and 24 minutes of daylight.
Oh, wow.
That's it. 9 hours and 24 minutes.
It's like a whole work day.
Yeah, right.
You go to work when it's dark, come home
when
it's dark.
I'm sure that's happening to a lot of people right now. But interestingly, the sunset starts getting later before that because the sunrise keeps getting later.
Later.
So we are in our earliest sunset time here in Baltimore right now. 4:43, the sun will go down this evening. And again, this is Tuesday the 3rd if you're listening. On the 15th, right before the solstice, the sunrise actually goes back to 4:44. What are you going to do with your extra minute of daylight?
I'm going to go run around the table 12 times.
Take the dining room table
outside. It's going to snow. I want it to be cloudy so it doesn't look like it's on.
That's funny. All right, so the next question is, when are we going to get a chance for somebody to win our snowfall contest?
Everyone wants to know when they're going to win. Because the prize is such a cool prize.
It is. You get a free Bill Vanko nature calendar signed by all three of us.
Yes.
Triple D, Bill Vanko, and myself. And that is a cool spot. If you've never seen it, what's Bill's website again?
Vanko, V-A-N-K-O, vision.com. Go to Google, type in V-A-N-K-O, vision.com. VankoVision.com. Fantastic photographer.
It is. It's really good. So that's what you can win. So when are we going to have a chance for somebody to win this prize? I don't think it's going to be this upcoming week.
Yeah, okay.
The next 7 days, it's actually going to get in the 50s early next week.
That's too warm for snow, Tony.
So unless we get that surprise dusting 6 inches tonight, but now that I've said it, it might happen.
It could happen.
The next chance I don't see happening until after maybe the 10th or the 12th.
Oh, okay.
So I know there's a lot of people like in the second and third week of December.
Oh yeah, we got it.
That picked. Yeah, we got it right there.
Right there.
You guys didn't think Triple D was actually paying attention, but he is. He's got everybody's name written down there.
I was keeping track.
So after the 10th or the 12th, there's a lot of indications pointing towards a more sustained cold pattern for us for the rest of December after that. And if you want to see one of the indications, go to my Twitter page or Twitter feed. And I posted something, page feed.
You can call
it
Twitter
a feed or a page?
It's both.
It's both.
If they go to Twitter itself, that's their Twitter feed. If they go to your page, it's your Twitter page.
Okay, good. So it's both. So I'm good either way.
Yeah, exactly.
That's why I have Triple D here. So he's young and hip, and he corrects me on all these
things. Thank you.
So anyhow, a lot of the long-range modeling, the ensemble members are showing an above-normal chance for snow here on the East Coast at the end of middle of December, end of December. And what I mean by that is you've heard us talking about the forecast modeling a lot on our podcast, the GFS in particular, right?
Yes.
Okay, so the Global Forecasting System, the GFS is the American model. And the one we normally post is what's normally called the operational model. But they actually run this model almost 50 different times.
Oh,
and
wow.
They change the math in each of the model runs slightly to see what kind of answer it gets.
Now, do they change the math? How can I put this? Do they just do it randomly, or do they do it based
on purpose?
It's based on
Certain parameters.
Oh, okay.
So they'll change. That's probably a better way to say it. They change certain parameters in each one of these ones, and we call them the ensembles. So
this is new.
Yeah, I know. I've never told you guys this before. So they literally run like 50 of these different variations of the same model, and then they take a consensus of the answer from each one of these 50 models and take the average output. And so in the ensemble average from the GFS long range for the rest of the month is pointing to, enough of those ensemble members pointed to an above average chance for snow after the middle of the month.
After the middle of the month.
Yes.
That's the 15th.
For us here in the mid-Atlantic.
Well, let's hope it's
so
not.
There you go.
Yes. Let's hope it's not the 19th.
Why? What happens on the 19th?
That's when the new Star Wars movie comes out. A lot of people are going to be standing out in line. Maybe one of them.
You're going to? Are you really? Are you really that much of a Star Wars fan?
Oh, absolutely. We're going. Yeah, we're going to see
it. I'm going to confess to you here.
Yeah.
I have only seen one, and it was the one that came out in the 70s, the very first one.
The first one. Well, you know, you're going to see one.
But, you know, they did it in a different sequence, right? That's actually not the first one in the story, right?
Yes, they did go back and the prequels is what they were called.
The prequels, yes.
You know, they gave you the origin of Darth Vader. And now we're finishing up this series of nine.
Triple D, I am your father.
you did christen me Triple D.
Yeah, right.
So kind of technically.
Yeah, yeah. We're getting off topic here, but what is this
topic.
One coming? What is this like in the sequence? Where is
this is the last one.
The last
The last of the Luke Skywalker.
There will be no more Star Wars movies after this?
There will
this?
Be Star Wars movies, but they won't be based around the original cast. There was no characters. There'll be offshoots.
Okay,
but,
so you guys didn't think we were going to break off into social stuff like this. This is awesome.
Yeah, that's why you keep me here.
That's because we talk about everything here.
Yes.
All right, so yeah, if you're going to stand in line on the 19th for the Star Wars movie.
Potentially will be, yes.
There is a chance that it could be snowing on you on the 19th. Yes. All right, so that's all I got for today. I hope everybody enjoyed our little podcast here. And if you want it to snow tonight, I've already done my part. I've jinxed it by saying a dusting. You know, I'm putting my own reputation on the line.
Again,
by saying the word dusting over and over. And so hopefully we'll get a little bit more snow than anticipated tonight. If not, just anticipate the dusting. And I think your next chance to win our contest is going to be in the middle of the month or the end of the month.
So sorry, everybody. Who's got this week?
All right. Hey, we had a great audience today. A lot of participation here. 90 comments.
Thanks,
on the Facebook feed. We really appreciate that. And thanks for participating. All right, for Tony Pan, for Tripper D, we're signing off. We will talk to you again. We're going to do it again Tuesday next week.
Yeah? Next Tuesday, yes.
Next Tuesday. Usually we do it on Wednesdays, but we're going to be on Tuesday next week around this same time. We will see you then.